Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back at long last to Let's Play Morrowind. I'm back from my break. Let's get started, shall we? So it's a bit of a recap. If you're wondering why I've been gone, there is an accompanying video that should be going up around the same time as this, which explains all of that, so I won't bore you with the details here. But to recap a bit, in case you've forgotten, because it has been a while. Here's the story so far. We are on the frozen island of Solfsheim in the north, up here. We're currently in Thirsk Mead Hall, which previously... Where is it on the map here? There it is. Thirsk Mead Hall. And previously, Faeryn was made the chieftain of Thirsk Mead Hall, something he wasn't terribly enthusiastic about, right up until the point where he discovered that Thirsk Mead Hall is actually a business which turns profit. And then that changed everything completely. So we're now the champion of Thirsk. And we've also been working with the Skarl village nearby to try and discover what has happened to the missing captain of Fort Frostmoth in the south. Largely out of idle curiosity, really, more than anything else, to pass the time a bit, I suppose, because, of course, Faeryn is up in Solfsheim, because he's lying low after a certain incident at the Vivek Temple that may or may not have happened in the previous chapter. Additionally, we've been helping setting up the colony of Ravenrock and being paid very handsomely for it indeed as well. So that's good news too. I don't know when next we need to go check that out, actually. We've ordered some mead from Skyrim. It should arrive in a week for the mead hall, which is good. Let's backtrack a little bit through here. We found Odford Whitelip for Gylia. Yes, we did that. Gylia the Mumbling. A mumbling soothsayer. Go to Ravenrock and see Falco. Yeah, the supply ship never turned up because it got shipwrecked and we rescued that woman. Thank you, phone. I don't know if you heard that in the background. It's just telling me someone went live on Twitch. That's what that is. Let's see. And we sorted that out and we got some miner's picks for Falco as well. We rescued Apronia. Yes, that's correct. Rewarded for those pickaxes. Carnius was furious at the news that the ship has been lost and that money would have to be spent to arrange for another ship. And the journal will update us when we're next able to go and do some more Ravenrock stuff. So for now, what we're going to be doing is actually heading up to the Skarl village to talk to the chieftain. Because previously, we went to Lake Fjolding to discover why there was a big fire burning in the middle of the ice lake, and it turned out because underneath it, there was a cave leading to a Draugr mage lord guy called Aeslip, who turned out not to actually be a baddie. He was working to keep some nasty frost atronachs or something trapped under the ice, and they were about to escape. So we aided Aeslip in defeating those frost atronachs, and he gave us a nice magic ring, which we're currently wearing. And then he died, I think, if I recall. But anyway. Yes. That's the story so far. We now need to go back to Skarl Village to report to Thast and the Heartfang that we were successful in dealing with the problem at the Ice Lake. Right. In the meantime, I have changed a few bits around in my inventory here after a little bit of an inspection of the gadgets I had and things like that. We are wearing Aeslip's Ring, which gives us plus 10 willpower and plus 50 magicka. We're wearing the Belt of the Unarmed, which is just such a good item. It's really good. We're wearing Denstagmer's Ring still to give us that elemental resistance, which is nice. And I'm wearing Radassar's Veil at the minute instead of the Amulet of Starvision. Because if I don't need Night Eye, I might as well wear Radassar's Veil, because not only does it give us 10 points of shield, it boosts our intelligence by 15 points, which is really nice. Gives us more magic, if that does. I've also swapped out my Telekinesis Glove for Treachery, which boosts my security by 20 points on self. Actually, no, not Treachery, sorry. Deceit, that was the one. I swapped it out for Deceit, because Deceit boosts our Sneak by 20 points, which actually gets my Sneak up to 75, which actually means that we might actually be able to sneak relatively effectively now, which is kind of nice. The telekinesis on constant effect is glorious, but actually, when I sit and think about it, is it all that useful most of the time? I mean, I can open doors from a bit further away if I'm feeling lazy, but most of the time you only really need telekinesis when you're dealing with a trapped chest or a trap door or something like that, and I can just quickly pop it on if we need to do that. So the rest of the time I might as well be wearing deceit so I can sneak around a little bit. And aside from that, I don't think there's anything else to remark upon. Oh, wait, no, I changed my helmet. I'm wearing the helm of the wolf's heart now instead of the snow wolf helmet, because I honestly think 4-5 sneak, another 5 points on self is not bad. But 4-5 agility, 5 points on self is actually quite nice. 5-point agility buff, because that'll make it easier for us to hit stuff in combat, that will. I think on balance, that's probably better than the 5% resist frost. If I'm fighting a frosty enemy, I can always pop it on. But also, I've got a magic belt that protects me from frost, as well as various potions and scrolls and spells and things as well. So, yeah, on balance, I think the Helm of the Wolf's Heart is a better choice, a better life choice. And so that's what we're wearing right now. That's more or less done. I think I did all of the inventory sorting last time before I signed off, didn't I? Yep. Oh, I popped my bear pelts down on the floor as a rug. Although I do want to take those back to Tel Uvirith with us when we leave Saltheim eventually, because I'd like to have some bear pelt rugs about the place as a bit of a souvenir. In fact, I might collect a few more from any more bears I find out there. Have I got any snow bear pelts by any chance, actually? Or did I drop them? No, I do have some snow bear pelts. Do they also turn into a rug when you drop them? They do, brilliant. I'm going to leave that there for now, because they're actually quite heavy, but yeah, I might have to skin a few more bears, actually, because I'd like to decorate Tel Uvirith with bearskin rugs. That's really cool. I don't think in the vanilla game it does that. It just, the thumbnail picture you can see there where I'm hovering over in the tooltip, I think that's what it normally looks like when you drop it on the floor in vanilla, but one of the mods has turned it into a rug when you drop it, and that's just such a genius idea. Well done, modders. Anyway. Yeah, like that. So, anyway, let's head downstairs. We'll be serenaded by the bard. That's what I wanted to hear. Beast, cut short its evil feast. And when the earth afflicted did fall, the chieftain claimed and came in. I don't know the words. We'll work on that, shall we? Right, let's go up to the Skelvage and prepare ourselves for what comes next. Because you guys got a little sneaky preview of what comes next last time. Oh, the fire is still in the lake. Also, the fire in the lake is actually part of a prophecy of the Bloodmoon, which caused Windeye over here, the Shaman, he did mention to us last time as well. It's a bit of a prophecy about something called the Bloodmoon, and a few of the elements of the prophecy seem to have come true. Seems no matter where Fathis goes these days, he's followed around constantly by prophecy. It's this, the Nerevarine prophecy, it's outrageous. Probably beginning to make him question whether or not he even has any free will. Ah, you guys are going to be a problem, aren't you? Two of you at the same time is a bit of a nasty combo. Can we please kill you quickly? There we go. I think he drank a potion then, but it didn't save him. There we go. Longbeard's increased to 79. That I do like. Can I loot you, please? Thank you. Anyway, we seem to be caught in another very quiet blizzard. Something going on with the sound effects in this expansion. I don't know what, but something odd's going on. Hello, everybody. It's me. I'm back. Yeah, not a great day to be wandering the snowy wild, is it really? Weather-wise. But hey. Right. Let us quick save. Thousand Heartfang. You've returned from the lake. You continue to surprise me, Father Sylvan. I have matters to attend to now. We will speak again soon, that I promise you.
Please, you must help. The village is under attack by the werewolves outside. Quickly. Yes. Horrible creatures. This many have not been seen in generations. Their appearances can only be a sign of dangerous things to come. Right. The village is under attack by werewolves. Let's quick save again. Now, the last time we did this... I'm going to move away a bit because that's quite loud. The last time we did this, I'm going to just stand here while the attack goes ahead. Yeah, the last time I did this, we were instantly killed by the werewolves because of a Morrowind code patch option I had turned on, which boosts hand-to-hand damage according to strength. And werewolves, their attacks count as hand-to-hand damage. Because they look like regular monsters, but I think as far as the game is concerned, they're actually considered NPCs. They're a bit weird. It's one of the reasons as well why they're one of the most nasty enemies in the game. I have since disabled that Morrowind code patch option, and hopefully, they'll probably still prove a bit of a challenge, but hopefully they're not going to kill me in like two hits this time. And by two hits, I mean one hit took away 90% of my health. Here we go. Okay, yeah, they still hit like a truck. But I don't think it's quite as bad as it was before. Having said that, yikes. But yeah, I did disable that option in the code patch, so that's definitely turned off. So this is definitely werewolves working slightly more as intended. Wow, yes. Well, this DLC is meant for high-level characters at the end of the day, but yeah. Okay, I still need to seriously prepare this time. Whenever this finishes loading. Do you know, I moved this game onto my new SSD recently, and yet it didn't load any faster at all. Morrowind's just weird, guys. It's just freaking weird. Right, let's put the Boots of the Apostle on instead of my Wolf Runner boots, because they've got better armor. Significantly better armor, in fact. And let's get some... Oh, the sound effects have gone. Let's get some shield spells on the go. God, I have so many spells. We have a bunch of summon spells we can do as well. That might be a good idea, actually. I might... I will try and fight them once more. If that fails, I will just levitate above them and summon things. and shoot them with spells. Scroll the first barrier. Do we have scrolls of slightly better barriers than that, by any chance? I don't think we do. I think I've used them all. Which is, not great. I have a second barrier belt, but I don't want to swap belts around right now, really, if I can help it. Well, my armor's boosted to 104, which isn't the best we could get it. Could use the cephalopod helm, actually. Let's do that. And... anything else? I don't know, really? The Bone Song. I could summon my skeletal horde if I use the belt, which summons my skeleton horde. However, doing that does occasionally crash the game, so I'm not sure if that's a great idea. yeah. They attack crocodile. Chance of that casting is actually quite low right now. That's interesting. Wait, no, I was looking at the wrong thing. I was looking at the Dwemer Animunculi. Ignore me. No, we have a great chance of casting the attack crocodile. Let's do it. Attack croc away. Yep. There we go. Oh my word. Okay then. Interesting. Well, I did turn off the thing in the code patch.
I definitely did that. So, oh well. The nuclear option is to just lower the difficulty. I guess I'll do that. Bit of a shame, but whatever. Because that's no good. We can't have that being killed in one hit. We have to stop this entire quest and come back when we're like level 60 or something at this rate, so that won't do. Oh, that's a... I should use that actually while I'm at it. I mean, Protective Spirit, I mean, I could do that. For 10 seconds I'd get 75 Sanctuary. And that would probably get me through fighting one werewolf, but like beyond that, no. No. First barrier, fourth barrier. I forgot this last time, actually. Boots of the Apostle. Shield. Cephalopod Helm. I could use Arian's glove to summon a bunch of Atronachs, but you know what? If I do that, they'll probably end up accidentally damaging the guards, and it'll cause a total kerfuffle. So I'd rather not do that, actually. Oops, just bumped the microphone. Apologies for that. Right, difficulty minus 100. Let's see if it works this time. See if it's remotely reasonable. Well, okay. I am one-shotting them this time, so... How does it feel now the tables are turned, you stupid werewolves? I get to two-shot you. God, they're almost killing me in spite of that, though. Did you see that? Good grief. Okay, that seems fair to me. Minus 100 difficulty against werewolves, yep. I can live with that. That still seems like a fair fight to me. My God. Right, it is. It's a bit irritating that every time we encounter werewolves, we're going to have to open this and adjust the difficulty. But I'm afraid it's just the way it's going to have to be for now, because I've twiddled the code patch, and that still hasn't helped. It would seem werewolves are just really, really nasty. I guess. Also, this would be a great opportunity. If you're playing the game as a heavy armor melee character, to get a full set of this awesome Nordic armor. We are not, though, and we don't need it, but yeah. One of the creatures went into the Great Hall, it must be stopped. Quickly into the Great Hall. Some of the beasts ran inside. There's the voice line I was waiting for. Right. I'm gonna bloody heal myself first, though. Good God. Where's half heal? Come on, Fabus. Come on. I know you're a bit rattled. Because you've met a worthy opponent for once. But seriously, man. Do not have enough magicka. Oh, bother. I've got plenty of restore health potions. Just take one of those, right? Oh, and if there is a werewolf in there. you guys are no joke at all, are you? Look at my health. Oh, we're boosting our restoration skill at least. Right, well, I see no sign of Fast and Heartfang, and one of his honor guards is dead. He's nowhere to be found. Have the werewolves abducted him like they did with Volkscarius? Quite possibly. Let's go and speak to someone outside. I wonder if Korst's around. Yes, there he is.
I know you have been infected by these werewolves.
Come again? I've only just arrived into this horror. It's good you are here to protect these people.
You have done well by the Skull. My worst fears have been realized, Fathers. These creatures are werewolves, as you surely know. This is not a good omen for our village, and I have more troubling news. I've used my magic to detect any of the infection these beasts leave in their wake. You, my friend, have been infected. The infection seems innocent enough. Some weakness, perhaps. Sometimes the effects are hardly noticeable. However, in 3 days' time, the victim will become a werewolf himself. It's a fate I would not wish upon my greatest foe. During these 3 days, though, a simple cure disease spell can stop the infection. I beg you to do this. Until then, I fear I cannot allow you to be part of our community, perhaps infecting others. When you've been cured, I hope you will return to us again. So, here, folks. Unlike in the main quest when you get infected with corpus disease, you actually have a choice. There we go. You actually have a choice here. You can actually wait for 3 days and become a werewolf. It's totally an option. Fathis isn't going to. Fathis has no intention of becoming a werewolf. Seems like a terrifically bad idea. To become one of these snarling beasts, powerful though they may be, with no control whatsoever. It's no interest whatsoever. Just as he has no interest in becoming a vampire either. It's fascinating that we managed to get infected with it in spite of, you know, being immune to disease, basically. But, yeah, which is interesting, because especially considering this DLC came out way after the main game was finished. And you could quite feasibly be playing with a high-level character that has completed the main quest at this point, you know, and is immune to disease. But whatever, we'll hand-wave that. I've been infected somehow anyway. So we will, in fact, drink a cure common disease potion. Luckily, I have a few of those around still for occasions such as this. And we will now speak to Korst. Ah, I no longer sense the infection in you. I'm happy for you, and for the Skull as well. You have proven to be a valuable member of this community. You've been true to our people, and the Skull name you Blood Skull, a blood friend to our people. You'll be given a home here, Rigmar Halfhand's former residence, in which you may rest. Also, it's been decided that you will take part in the Restark, an important Skull ceremony. Alright, so we have a house here in the village we can stay at, which is nice. The Restark, you say? A ceremony of blessing and cleansing that we Skull perform only very rarely. These are frightening times, my friend. There have been ominous portents, and they concern me. The Heartfang is missing, and I fear that the Allmaker does not breathe freely on the Skull this day. The ceremony must be completed, but first, I will need you to retrieve the Totem of Claw and Fang. It is a powerful artifact, very sacred to the Skull people. It's used to call us on powerful beasts. Call to us powerful beasts that are used in the Restark. It was stolen many years ago, and we of the Skull were foolish enough to believe it would not again be needed. I've learned that it may be found in the tombs of Skalara, to the east and a bit south of here. Please, return the totem. Alright. Anything about the Bloodmoon prophecy? Doesn't want to speak about it. Rigmar Halfhand? Yeah. Total Claw and Fang. Restarg. Okay, so you must find the Totem of Claw and Fang. To the east and a bit south of here. So that would be this way somewhere. That's Rimhull. Oh, that's the other entrance to Rimhull. It's not this well here, it's this well here. We might pop down into Rimhull on our way. But yeah, it should be around here somewhere, though, and I would guess. Alright, well. We're on Rod the Roarer's house. Which one's mine? Here it is, the Blood Skull's house. Okay. I'd rather wait out the blizzard, if I'm honest. Yeah, it's more or less as it was left. I think. But yeah, another player home for us. We don't really need it. I'm kind of living at Thirsk at the moment, really. But it's good that it's there. What time is it? 9 a.m. I think we're going to rest here for the remainder of the day, actually. Because of the blizzards. Like, we could just head out there, but realistically, you wouldn't. You would wait for the blizzard to end before heading out, because you'd just get lost in it, or freeze to death, or, yeah, it'd be very stupid. So, right, let's give it a minute, see if it clears up. You know what it's like sometimes, the weather in this game. If it doesn't clear up, I'll go anyway. Anyone else got anything to say? Worski Talahand? It's not really clearing up, is it? How's the condition of my armor and stuff? You know what? I'm gonna visit the smith and get it repaired a bit. Those werewolves hit pretty hard after all. Yeah, not cheap that, but needs to be done. Right. Is the difficulty still set? Yeah, it is. Right. Set it back to zero, although I suspect we might encounter more werewolves relatively soon, so... And yeah, okay, good. The blizzard is dying down. Great. So, having rested for the rest of the day in the village... This morning... The following morning, we set out on our quest. Now, where is this? It's up here, is it? Looking for a well or something. Here it is. Trapdoor to Rimhell Lock. Luck level 100. Well. I'll see if I can get this open with the battering ram spell, and if I can't, then I'll probably just leave it. Oh dear. Well. Alright, we'll give it another go. I'll wait here until my magicka comes back. Hold up. Right. I am back, and we've got some more magicka. Let's do it again. That's more like it. Right. Oh god, I'm underwater. Okay, it's a well, isn't it, I suppose. Bit of water breathing. There we go. That's better. In fact, I'll also pop this on. So I can maybe see a bit better. I decided to go to the toilet while I was waiting for the magicka to recharge. And I know you probably don't want to hear this, but I'm going to tell you anyway. I had some really super, super spicy Korean noodles for dinner last night. And I tell you what, right now my ass feels like the business end of a flamethrower. Whew! there were some really spicy noodles. Like, one of the spiciest things I've ever eaten. I was sweating buckets afterwards. They were so good, though. Hello. Skeleton berserkers? Oh dear. You've been foiled by the geometry, haven't you? How very sad. Let me put you out of your misery. What do we have here? Any treasure worth having? What am I saying? Of course not. Actually, that's quite a lot of potions, isn't it? Paralysis, I will always take that. Poison as well is not bad. Reflect, restore fatigue, restore health. What about you? You have big axe, a wolf gauntlet, and restore health. Alright. So where does this lead? to death. And skeletons. Oh god, the one of them's got a bow. Take cover. This is a skeleton that's been dead for some time. A skeleton of the non-animated variety. Definitely preferred, on the whole. Oh no, you don't have a bow. I thought you did for some reason. Ouch. That hurt a bit, that did. What have I just done? I pressed the wrong hotkey and something's happened. So one, two, three, four, five. I just put on the levitation belt, that's what happened. Oops. Oh, hello. What I'm trying to find right now is half heal. Never mind. Right, okay. Let's rebind to leech health. Hello, Tim Ball. We meet again, a slightly different timeline.
Intruder, who dares venture so deeply into the halls of Rimhull? The mantle of woe is mine, do you hear? I have claimed the rule bandit's power. Behold the vestments I now wear. When I read the old stories, I had to learn the truth. Read the old stories. Oops. Could it be that such an item of such grand magicka lay so close at hand in the caves beneath my very village? I could contain my eagerness no longer and jumped into the well. I braved Rimhull's dangers and at last my efforts were rewarded. Soon the dead shall walk and Timval the Dark shall lead them.
This is the most fathis answer, I think.
Such power must never be wielded by one so feeble. The mantle will be mine. So you seek the mantle's power for your own. A dark jewel it shall be then.
You should have picked an easier opponent.
You say that, but, I think last time I did this, I unleashed my skeleton army on him, which was a bit more poetic, really, but, Mantle of Woe, there it is, value 10,000. Drain personality 100 points on self, which would explain why he was such an unpleasant individual. Weakness to normal weapons, 20% on self. Fortify maximum magicka 5 times int on self, which is huge. This would boost our magicka by a humongous amount. It also gives you sun damage. But it does fortify conjuration 50 points as well, which is pretty cool. So this is... The weakness to normal weapons a bit. Ugh. Because that will actually stack with the weakness to normal weapons 20% on Belt of the Unarmed. Which is not great. I do wonder if that's worth taking that off when I'm fighting werewolves, you know. But, yeah, because that gives 40% weakness to normal weapons, which is a bit grim. But, yeah. The boost to our magicka would be unbelievable. Boost to our conjuration is incredible as well, actually. You just can't use it outdoors, really, because of the sun damage. And, probably best not to wear it in towns either on account of the drained personality. I shall take it. Don't know how much I'll actually use it, but I shall take it. Let's see. Let's remove the wolf helmet for a second. It certainly looks very Fathis. It definitely works. Fashion-wise. It has boosted our magicka now to 576. It's like playing as an Altman now, this is. It's like playing as a high elf. Craziness. Craziness. Imagine if you were a high elf and you got this item. That's like game-breaking levels of magicka at that point. That's like when you get to gold tier Morrowind, when you have that kind of thing going on. But, yeah, pretty cool. This is an incredibly rare enchantment as well, that fortify maximum magicka times 5, like by a multiplier. You almost never see that.
But yes. Very cool. However, right now, not going to be using it. Because I need to be outdoors right now. And sun damage is not fun. Right, not that there's much sun right now, but it's not how the game sees it, I'm afraid. Right, keep an eye out for those stupid ice worms. I don't want to have to fight a bunch of them. And let's go find this. So, did he say west or east? Oh, it's east and south of it. Right, I was going westwards. I'm sure somebody said. Squirrel. Your health is mine, squirrel. Now then, yes, I'm sure someone said earlier when I was pointing over here on the map, oh, Dave, that's the west, that's not the east, that's the west. You can delete your comment now, dear viewer. It's fine, I figured it out. Not that east, the other east. Would you please leave me alone? I can't turn you into a rug, so I'm not particularly interested in killing you. Is there another berserker over there? I do believe it is. Let's leave you alone then. Ah, heaven's sake. Do you have a gold coin for me? You do! Thank you very much. Coin for my trouble. Right. So. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. I am going to have to leave it for this episode, I'm afraid. I'm looking at the time now and I'm thinking, yeah, I'm going to have to go, I'm afraid. However, I'm back. I'm recording more Morrowind. You'll be hopefully happy to hear. And next time, ladies and gentlemen, we will find the Totem of Claw and Fang. And probably fight a bunch more werewolves while we're at it. Oh, bunny rabbit! You, come here, you. Excellent. Thanks so much for watching, folks. I'll catch you next time.